Return. What does arithmetic operator return? What type of data type? What do we get out of it? Like if we add two numbers, what do we get? Well, the data type. What data type? Number, yeah, right. This number. Now, on what data types can I apply the comparison operators? Like the kind of data type. No, this is numeric. I'm sorry. Boolean. I mean, it's not written. I mean. On what kind of data I can use comparison operators, or they call as operands. What is operands data type? Operands are those variables which are the victims of these operations. Numeric, yeah. So the data type, I can only say two numbers are I can only compare with numbers. Yeah, you're right, but for less than and greater than, okay, less than or equal to or greater than or equal to, it's numeric, whereas equal to and not equal to, okay, equal to and not equal to can be any data type. Let's say any in the sense, yeah, it can be Boolean, it can be string, it can be numeric, okay. So the data type of the operands for greater than, less than, sorry, less than, greater than, okay, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, is strictly numeric, because I can only say two numbers to be greater than or less than. But yeah, for the equal to, the data type of the operands for equal to and not equal to. Like say just two strings. Say suppose my name and your name. I can compare my name and your name too. Like if they are equal, if they are not equal, right? I can compare two statuses, like you know the results. Like say if the status equal to false, if the status is not equal to false. So I can compare using equal to, I mean equal to and not equal to on any kind of data type. On numeric, string and Boolean. Okay, so this is about the two operators, the arithmetic and comparison, and I'll jump into the next operator. So guys, any questions here? I can just answer your questions, or yes, any questions here? So the next is logical. Okay, we'll see an example for arithmetic. Yes, any questions here? So logical operators. Now, logical operators. When do we use it? The logical operators. Any idea? So what is exactly logical operator mean? Yes, any idea? Formulas, like example. Say, I'll give you guys an example. You guys will be knowing about it. Now what I say is like, okay, there's a number which is less than 10, okay, and greater than 8, okay, I'll write it here. There is a number which is greater than sorry, yeah, greater than 8 and less than 10. So what is this number? Nine. So, but there are two conditions here. There are two comparisons here. One is I should check for if this number is greater than 8. Okay, what do I get? What's the result? What does it return? If this number is greater than, I say let's say where number equal to 9. Okay, so number, I'll say greater than 8. What does it return? Number less than 10. What does this return? Now tell me the return value. Return value. Tell me. So what does this return? Number greater than 8. And this returns true. Right? So it's a condition. I'm saying number equal to 9. Now number is 9 and 9 is greater than 8. So what does it return? Like it returns, yeah, this is true. 9 is greater than 8. Now 9 is less than 10. What does it say? Yeah, this is true. Now both of them are true. Hence, okay, the condition has been met. So now when do you use logical operator? If you guys can see it here, I already used a logical operator. I said 9. Okay, so whenever I want to check two logical, or let's say equations at the same time. Okay, so if two conditions have to meet, okay, or either of the conditions have to meet, or none of them should be true, or at least one should be true, or both of them should be true. So there are several conditions over there. Like, you know, if this is not true, then this must be true, or let both of them be true, or even at least, you know, one of them to be true or both of them to be false. So this is logical operation. Hey, you gotta make a decision over there. So whenever I gotta make some decision based upon some inputs, yeah, it's logic, right? So logical operators are used when I have to make some decisions based on multiple inputs. If it is just one input, like say, give me a number which is greater than 8, or give me a number which is less than 10, then I have multiple options over there. I can give from minus infinity to 9, right? So it is single condition. So I can compare, like if 9 less than 10, 8 less than 10. So but what if I have two conditions? Then instead of writing two statements, I can evaluate both of the conditions in the same line using my logical operators. So logical operators are used to make some decisions based on multiple inputs, let's say. Okay, so the logical operators here, just give me a second, the microphone is gone. So the logical operators here are and, okay, this is and two pipe symbols, this is R and there is not. Okay, this is called logical and, logical R and logical not. Okay, so here, so the operands here may be multiple or more than two. Okay, minimum two and maximum can be many. Okay, it's only two every time. The operands are only two every time. Yeah, now we'll see. Suppose, let's say where first number equal to 10, where second number equal to 12, where third number equal to let's say 8. Okay, now I have to make a decision such that, you know, just I have some set of 1000 numbers. I don't know which number to pick, but I'll give a condition such that this number should be, you know, either of any of this number. If the number which I'm feeding from my input